Oh, what day is it? March 14th?
13th.
March 13th at like 10:30 a.m. or something. Out here in the middle of somewhere. This is out in Medford. So we're on this two-story, 612, 30 square approximately. And we're putting down estate gray. Got Deco-Ridge, we're doing ridge vent up here. And this is where we at.
We got
one bundle put down. And then we left because the guy wanted us to do a lot of stuff and didn't have the time for it. So we got what we could done, and now we're back. All the metal's put on. We got some more like starter strips. So what?
Just look at the
felt. Yeah. It's a big old mess out here, but it's okay.
We didn't do it.
She's right. Wasn't us. I didn't felt it either. Homeowner did this. I'm just here to slap some shingles, so I've been adding nails over this felt to hold it down a little more. What happened?
I don't know.
You broke your finger. Why'd you do that? Not good. Well,
actually, it might be chalk.
Oh, probably is. You know, see? Chalk everywhere. Anyways, we're gonna continue running out these first four rows all the way across, and then run some books up. Maybe we'll actually start with the starter roll. Run that up both the gables.
Already been here for 2 hours.
Same day, approximately 12:12. Been here like 2 hours.
Yeah.
And now we got all that starter strip, all but a little piece over there, and that gable edge right there. And that the starter strips put down. Both gable ends ran up and all the way around. So now we're gonna go throw some estate gray, finish running out these first four, and see how much of this side we can get knocked out today. These are easy, like two bundle up runs. It's 27 feet or something, 28 feet, I don't know. It should be about two bundles up and a piece of cake, so.
Easy peasy.
Easy peasy. Well, porter cable gun, this gauge, you see how easy that just slides around? That's the adjustment, so you can adjust it, but then you lock it and it just slides all over the place. Well, it stays on point for the first nail or the first shingle, then it just starts scooting down. This one's adjusted for, I don't even know what, Harbor Freight, porter cable, both crap. We're gonna go get a max so we can sink a nail without smacking every single one. That's just a waste of time. So we'll come back here and maybe start getting something done, but until then, we'll be back.
Old Dodgy. Now that's an 82. Yeah. 82, this is an 83.
Okay,
this is the commercial.
Oh, okay. Yeah,
and then I've got the
commercial. No. Thanks.
Muddy shoes? No good.
No good.
What time is it?
Oh.
It is 4:30.
4:30?
We had to go get a good hammer.
That's a max super roofer. This gauge? Tight. This is a good one.
That's a good one.
I'm gonna go slap some shingles now.
Yeah. We tried to go find me some bibs because these jeans are gonna be destroyed.
Yeah.
No luck.
Jeans don't work so good. They work, but long-term ability isn't quite there, you know?
Yeah. This is all we have done.
Huh?
4:30, but the time changed today, so we have an extra hour of light.
Yeah, we'll be here till 7 o'clock
tonight. Seven. We got, that's probably the fifth bundle. So almost to 2 square.
Yeah.
Probably be here. It's Sunday. Probably be here till Wednesday working on this. unless we knock it out the next 2 days.
We'll be done eventually.
And then picked up another gig, so we'll be here like all week. Yeah, yeah.
Who knows? We might never go home.
He's going to be so mad at me. Because I'm not wearing earplugs or glasses. See if he notices. So, since we didn't have a gauge for this whole, how many? 5 square.
Roughly.
We have to measure both sides and see how, if any, we're off. How much? So I measured from the top of the plywood at the ridge to the top of the shingles, which was 17 feet, 8 inches, and 5/16. Learned how to read the tape measure by 16ths today. And we're gonna finish this section here.
One more shingle,
and then we'll know. Okay. So we got 17, 8. So we were there on that side. So we're off by 5 inches.
Yeah, we're off a ways. 8 inches. Hold on. Yeah, that's a doozy right there.
Okay. So we finished, I think we're at 5 square with that bundle.
15?
Yeah. 5 square so far. It is like, what, 5:30?
Somewhere around there.
I think we easily could have done 10 square today if we had.
Yeah.
I mean, we basically started this at 4.
You're right. Yeah, we started this hella late.
Because of the time change, and then...
Yeah.
So, yeah, we're at 5 square in about 3 hours today. Possibly.
See, all you need is the right tool for the job. This gauge, so important. This gauge should be the same distance right here as it is that laminate. If you can tell, there's a line right there. Hooks on the bottom should match with the top. That's exactly 5 5/8 inches. If it starts moving around, you're a 16th of an inch off. There's 22 shingles to a bundle. In a one bundle run, you'll be inch and a quarter off over a one bundle up.
And that's what could have happened today.
That causes a big problem at the end. You start getting bird's mouths and bad stuff.
We had to chalk lines.
Yeah, you see, we had to chalk 17 lines because of that porter cable gun.
So we chalked lines all the way across this roof instead of the gauge, and we think it worked out. But Talon is, what are you doing?
Finishing up the rake edge now.
So we gotta cut. We get to the end.
Hey, throw me that one.
The one I cut. Upside down, sorry. Got to cut them to the right size. But you can't have one that's less than 4 inches.
Yeah, if it's smaller than the width of your palm. But we'll run into that in a little bit. I'll show you how that works. Make a tick right there.
Slice and dice.
Kenzie didn't know what to do because it's got right there. Just throw it over here. If you get a damaged shingle, if it has a forklift bite or whatever, you can use that majority of the time. always use them on the rake ends. Sometimes they work out on rake. Top, always use the top of the shingle for cutting this. I like to flip the shingle upside down. Get your hook blade.
So then if you nick the top, it doesn't show. Yeah.
Exactly. That's hidden under the overlap of the next shingle.
And if you couldn't tell, we're pretty high up. So we're hooked in. How high up are we, you think?
This is a two-story. I don't know. They're about 20-foot walls, I think.
Six total square. Hopefully, we fixed the 5 inches we were off. I believe we did. Whatever. Talon will have to explain whatever he did.
A what?
You'll have to explain whatever you did to get it back on track.
Yeah, we'll maybe we'll write it down on paper once we get back to Buffalo.
Buffalo.
Write it down on some paper. I'll show you. It makes a lot of sense.
Yep. So he's gonna finish up bundle number 16.
I think it was 18.
18, because we did 6 square already. And I'm gonna go clean up all this junk and we'll be done for the day. That was only about 6 hours. 6 square and 6 hours of total work, including about an hour or two we did when we first got here on Friday, and then only about 4 hours today because everything's been ridiculous. But tomorrow, everything's gonna be set in stone. Probably get this whole side done. Talon's sick.
Yeah, I'm unwell. Well, yesterday kind of didn't feel great. It was all right. Got done with the day super achy. Today, woke up trashed. And took a little stuff, still trashed. But I have no choice but to get to it. We had a good nail gun. We got stuff to do today. So we're gonna get to it.
It's a dimple.
It's a dimple. Why are you videotaping my eyeball? Cough drop. Bookmaking. 101. Stair step, staircase, whatever you want to call it. You go 5 5/8 inches. Luckily for me, the body of this hook blade, right here, the body of it is precisely 5 5/8 of an inch. So what I'll do, go right here. Oh wait, I already cut one. 5 5/8 right there, times 2, boom, mark it, and then I got a little pouch to hold the knife. Homeowner just gave me this tool to try. Cutting two books at once. There's 3 shingles to 1 book. I'm just cutting 2 at a time. And then This is 11 and a quarter plus 5 5/8 right here. We can go ahead and mark that. I'll do this with a knife, or I have one of those AJC shingle shears, like a giant table tool, and that works fantastic. Set them up like this. This is what I've found to be most efficient. It does take a couple minutes to lay out, but in the end, it's more organized.
Create stairs.
Yep. I'll tell you when.
We put on the red light.
Frustration. These ones are extra tough.
These ones are next to the top.
Talon.
Hey.
How do you know how many books to cut?
Oh, that's a great question. Well, the way I know, let's say it's a fairly, typically what I'll do, I'll count how many rolls of felt there are. On this roof, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 rolls of felt paper. Each roll of felt paper is equivalent to roughly one book. I mean, you see here, we're on the fifth roll, and we're 3 head laps over. Each roll of felt is equivalent to 1 book. If you count 7 rolls of felt, pre-cut 7 books. I don't do that because I don't want my books sliding off the roof or going anywhere, and I don't want to have a big mess to deal with. So I'm cutting them as I need. I try to cut 2 at a time just to save a little bit of time. And they're easy to deal with. Now we're gonna run this up one more, get one more book up here, and shoot it across.
Beautiful.
All right here, we have our books ran up. We're probably at 4 or 5 bundles for that. We're probably almost 2 square in. Shoot these across, and it's gonna be great. This is what we like to see. This is what we want. So now, we're just gonna
knock it out.
Go. Easy as that. Let's go.
It is 2:00. Just
what?
Took a 2-hour lunch. Oopsie.
Yeah, it was pretty long.
But goal is to have this section done by 3 an hour.
I took a long break, okay.
I'm sorry.
Chick-fil-A. In and out, worth it. But I think we can get this done. Get this whole half of the roof done today. Start the other side. Easy peasy lemon squeezy.
Easy. Well, it's 3:48. three, four, eight. We got this side virtually done. We have the last 2 feet, obviously, because of the bundles. Over here, this big section, it's about a, I think it was something along the lines of a 60-foot run. We got those first four runs put down. Now, tomorrow we're gonna come back, cut books, run those up. Maybe not tomorrow, maybe Wednesday. I think we're getting rained out tomorrow. Oh, but I think once we get the bundles, once we get the books cut, we could we get most of the side knocked out in a day, easy.
Easy peasy.
This is about a 15 square section, I think.
15 square,
roughly. I think it's
good.
But we're gonna go do some quick cleanup, pick up our wrappers, and get a bundle count for the day. And get out of here before the rain starts. So,
yeehaw.
Yeah.
It's Wednesday, March 16th. Day. Who knows anymore on the roof?
I don't know. A lot.
This is our second full day.
Second actual real day.
Actual real day. Just a reminder of that. Cutting books. I don't really know why he's cutting them on top of the other shingles.
Well, I'm pulling it up so it won't sting.
Two books at once. And we're knocking this whole side out today. Hopefully. That would be nice.
We got 4 minutes. That shouldn't be too bad.
It's a nice day. It'll be good. Yeah. Just after 11 today, but it's too icy this morning.
Yeah, we went shopping, didn't get anything, but we just looked around and had some fun.
Just need some work bibs. No one has any my size, so that's a bummer. But this whole side is wet, kind of sketch. But it'll dry out soon.
Nails?
Take my eyes open to reality.